kids, welcome back. Yesterday we learnt about factors. Also, we learnt that how to find factors by multiplication. Let's revise this concept by solving C part of question 2 of exercise 5. So kids, we know that 1 is a factor of every number and every number is a factor of itself. So the first multiplication fact, that is 1 multiplied by 16 here, will give you 16. That means 1 and 16 are the factors of 16. Now all other factors will lie between 1 and 16, right? So let's now check whether 2 is a factor of 16 or not by division. So if we divide 16 by 2, we get the remainder as 0. That means 2 is a factor of 16, and the quotient, which is 8, will also be the factor of 16. So let's write the multiplication fact for this, which is 2 multiplied by 8 is equal to 16. Now let's check whether 3 is a factor or not. So on division of 16 by 3, we get a remainder 1, because 3 fives are 15, and when we subtract 15 from 16, we get a remainder 1. That means 3 is not a factor. Also, if you divide by 5, so again you will get the remainder 1 and quotient as 3. That means it is vice versa. So you may say that 3 and 5 both are not the factors. So let's move to number 4. Let's divide 16 by 4. Kids, this gives us a remainder 0. That means number 4 is a factor of 16. So let's write the multiplication fact for this, which is 4 multiplied by 4 is equal to 16. And kids, we have learnt that we write a number only once, no matter how many times the number is repeating itself. So the factors of 16 are 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. Let's do one more part, which is H part. The number given to you is 55. So kids, the first multiplication fact which will give us the factors would be 1 multiplied by 55 is equal to 55. That means all other factors will lie between these two factors, that is 1 and 55. Now, if you divide 55 by 2, you will observe that it leaves a remainder. So that means 2 is not a factor of 55. Let's try by 3. Now, on division of 55 by 3, again we are left with some remainder. That means 3 is also not a factor of 55. Now, let's try by 4. Kids, division by 4 will also leave a remainder. That means 4 is also not a factor of 55. So let's now try by 5. On division by 5, we are left with remainder 0. That means 55 is completely divided by 5, and the quotient is 11. So let's write the multiplication fact for this, which is 5 multiplied by 11 is equal to 55. That means 5 and 11, both numbers are the factors of 55. Now, if we check for 6, 7, 8, all these numbers will leave remainder if we'll divide 55 by these numbers. So all these are not the factors of 55. So we will stop here and we will write the factors of 55 are 1, 5, 11 and 55. Let's now do question number 4 of this exercise. It says, check if the second number is a factor of the first number. So kids, in order to check whether the second number is a factor of first number or not, we will divide the first number by second number. And if it is completely divisible by second number, then we will say that second number is a factor of first number, otherwise not. So let's do A part. The numbers given to you are 20 and 5. So we will divide 20 by 5 here and we will check if we get a remainder or not. So here when we divide 20 by 5, the remainder is 0. That means the division of 20 by 5 does not leave any remainder. That means 5 is a factor of 20. Let's take a look on D part now. The numbers given to you are 154 and 5. Now kids, when you divide 154 by 5, you will find that there is a remainder 4 left. So you will say that since 154 divided by 5 leaves a remainder, so 5 is not a factor of 154. Let's now check G part. The numbers given to you are 45 and 0. Now kids, here we have to check whether 0 is a factor of 45 or not. That means we will divide 45 by 0, which is not possible because we know that we cannot divide any number by 0. So you will write, since we cannot divide any number by 0, so 0 is not a factor of 45. I hope you have got this concept.